and low payment is the main reason as to why teachers quit their profession in Uganda, and now the coronavirus pandemic has increased their pressures. Despite all these challenges, French teachers have vowed not to quit their profession, adding that the future is bright amidst the pandemic. This was during the closure of 10 days training on French for specific purposes attended by 30 French language teachers from four public universities at Makerere University Business School. We have more.
The French on specific purposes that has been happening for 10 days at MOBS in Akawa has been conducted by Paul Mendes, associate professor from Cape de Verde, and has been supported by the French embassy in Uganda. While receiving their certificates at the closing ceremony, participants revealed how beneficial the training has been. The participants say teaching is challenging but rewarding as a profession.
Me as the director of Bonjour Kampala, we give opportunities to students and teachers to go on our website, bonjourkampala.com, in order to learn. We are designing some programs. We are designing some programs with teachers of Uganda in order to help them in terms of learning online. And for that project, we are working as well with TV5 Monde, which is a TV whereby you go and you design, we download some programs, and then you can be able to teach by yourself than having even a teacher.
For us at the university, we are still working even when there is COVID. We've been teaching our students online. We can as well teach students elsewhere in the world. When we're in Uganda, we don't need to travel to go to other countries to get work. We just need to place ourselves right. Even I advise the youngsters, those students who did French, to just be strategically placed. They can still be within Uganda and they are working abroad, for example. With this new technology, anything is possible. Let them just open up, let them change their attitude, let them be pragmatic. Everything can, the world can change.
School closure implies a massive loss in the development of human capital with significant long-term economic and social implications. While this is a stress-free test for education systems, it is also an opportunity to develop alternative education opportunities.
We've learned much more on how we can teach French for specific groups. For example, the tourists, the pilots, the drivers, the journalists, they don't need to learn literature or to write poems, no. They need French in their specific fields, and they need it for survival. I mean, why should I come to a hotel and I speak French and no one can speak French? I would be very uncomfortable. So I would want to be in a place where I'm able to say something and they understand me.
The French for specific purposes is needed in this country. What do we mean? We should be able to give you the dose of the journalism which you need for carrying out your journalistic work. We should be able to help the URA people clear very well. I want to share with you a funny experience. I went to clear my books in URA, but I asked for a waiver, for instance, a tax waiver. My books constituted teacher's guide learner's book, and learner's book in French is cahier d'exercice. So the person in the URA clearly said, "Madam, why are you importing exercise books from France?" I said, "No, I cannot import exercise books from France. We have them here in the country." So what was, they were misinterpreting the word cahier d'exercice. So I'm like, we need to sensitize Ugandans because you don't have to translate directly.
The 30 French language teachers that attended came from universities such as MOBS, Makerere University, Kabale University and Chambogo University, organized in partnership with Alliance Francais Kampala and Campus of France. Story by Simon Semazi for the news.